The geopolitical landscape of the Middle East has undergone a significant transformation since the landmark rapprochement between Saudi Arabia and Iran in March 2023, mediated by China. The rivalry between these two regional powers, historically a defining feature of regional politics, is now showing signs of recalibration. This shift is unfolding against the backdrop of Saudi Arabia's efforts to balance its long-standing alliance with the United States and its burgeoning ties with Iran. If you are new to our channel, please leave a sub as well as a like so you never miss another video. China's successful mediation in 2023 culminated in the Beijing Agreement, a milestone accord aimed at de-escalating tensions between Saudi Arabia and Iran. Beijing, a major purchaser of oil from both nations, has actively encouraged deeper economic and political cooperation between the two countries. This mediation has provided Iran with much-needed economic prospects and open avenues for Riyadh to address its strategic goals, including economic diversification under Vision 2030. A notable development in the post-rapprochement era has been Saudi Arabia's proposal to bolster trade with Iran, despite existing sanctions. These trade initiatives are focused on non-controversial sectors such as food and medical products, with potential involvement of private Saudi companies and third-party countries like Iraq. Iran's ambitions to increase the trade volume to $1 billion annually underline the economic stakes now at play. Furthermore, Saudi Arabia has made headlines with its new decision to abandon its pursuit of a comprehensive defense treaty with the United States, which was contingent upon normalizing relations with Israel. This shift is primarily due to the ongoing Israeli military operations in Gaza and the resulting surge of public anger across the Middle East. The relationship between the United States and Saudi Arabia has evolved significantly since its inception in the early 20th century, encompassing economic, political, and military dimensions. The early relations between the two countries were forged in the 1930s, when the United States officially recognized Saudi Arabia as a newly unified kingdom under the leadership of King Abdulaziz Al-Saud. This recognition came at a time when Saudi Arabia's vast potential in natural resources was beginning to attract global interest. In 1933, the U.S.-based Standard Oil of California, SoCal, was granted a concession to explore for oil in the kingdom, leading to the groundbreaking discovery of oil in the Damam field in 1938, a moment that transformed Saudi Arabia into an emerging oil powerhouse. The oil discoveries fostered the establishment of Aramco, the Arabian American Oil Company, a consortium of U.S. companies that would dominate Saudi Arabia's oil production for decades. By the late 1930s, Saudi Arabia's oil reserves were recognized as among the largest in the world, a reality that shaped the early contours of U.S.-Saudi relations. Oil quickly became the cornerstone of the bilateral relationship, as it provided the U.S. with critical energy resources and Saudi Arabia with the technology and expertise to exploit its newfound wealth. The strategic importance of Saudi Arabia grew exponentially during World War II. In 1945, President Franklin D. Roosevelt met with King Abdulaziz aboard the USS Quincy in the Suez Canal, a historic meeting that resulted in the Quincy Agreement, an informal yet pivotal understanding that would underpin U.S.-Saudi relations for decades. The U.S. committed to defending Saudi Arabia's sovereignty in exchange for guaranteed access to its oil resources. During the war, Saudi Arabia's oil production, though limited, became vital to Allied operations. The post-war period saw exponential growth in oil production, with Saudi Arabia emerging as a critical supplier of energy to global markets. The Quincy Agreement also marked the beginning of a security for oil arrangement, which laid the groundwork for a long-term strategic partnership. The Cold War era witnessed Saudi Arabia becoming a crucial U.S. ally in the Middle East, particularly in the context of containing the spread of Soviet influence in the region. However, the relationship faced its first significant test during the 1973 oil embargo, in response to U.S. support for Israel during the Yom Kippur War. Saudi Arabia and other OPEC nations cut oil exports to the U.S., triggering a global energy crisis. Oil prices skyrocketed, quadrupling from $3 to $12 per barrel, and the embargo caused severe economic disruptions in the West. Despite these tensions, the U.S. and Saudi Arabia managed to rebuild their relationship. The embargo underscored Saudi Arabia's geopolitical leverage as an oil supplier and prompted the U.S. to develop domestic energy policies, including the establishment of the Strategic Petroleum Reserve in 1975. Throughout the remainder of the Cold War, Saudi Arabia continued to serve as a reliable partner, supporting U.S. efforts to counter communism and stabilize the region. The 1990 Iraqi invasion of Kuwait marked a turning point in U.S.-Saudi relations. Faced with the threat of Iraqi aggression, Saudi Arabia sought U.S. military assistance to defend its borders. The resulting Operation Desert Storm saw the deployment of over 500,000 U.S. troops to Saudi Arabia, making it one of the largest military mobilizations in American history. This intervention successfully expelled Iraqi forces from Kuwait and protected Saudi sovereignty. Saudi Arabia played a significant financial role in the conflict, contributing an estimated $60 billion to support the war effort. The Gulf War solidified the military alliance between the two nations, with the U.S. maintaining a substantial military presence in Saudi Arabia throughout the 1990s. The September 11, 2001, attack severely strained U.S.-Saudi relations. The revelation that 15 of the 19 hijackers were Saudi nationals led to heightened scrutiny of Saudi Arabia's role in fostering extremist ideologies. Critics in the U.S. accused the kingdom of allowing Wahhabi teachings to promote radicalism, further complicating the bilateral relationship. In response, Saudi Arabia intensified its counterterrorism efforts, working closely with U.S. intelligence agencies to dismantle terrorist networks, including Al-Qaeda in the Arabian Peninsula. The 21st century has brought new challenges and opportunities for U.S.-Saudi relations. The two nations collaborated extensively to combat the rise of ISIS in the 2010s, with Saudi Arabia hosting coalition forces and providing logistical support. However, the conflict in Yemen emerged as a controversial issue, as the U.S. provided arms and intelligence to the Saudi-led coalition fighting the Houthi rebels, despite the high civilian toll of the conflict leading to growing criticism in the U.S. Congress. The 2018 murder of journalist Jamal Khashoggi further strained relations, prompting bipartisan calls in the U.S. for a reassessment of arms sales and strategic ties. Despite these challenges, the relationship persists, driven by mutual interests in energy security and regional stability. Arms sales have continued, with Saudi Arabia purchasing approximately $64 billion worth of U.S. weapons between 2015 and 2021. Under the Biden administration, the U.S.-Saudi relationship has experienced fluctuations. Initially, President Biden pledged to reassess ties, emphasizing human rights concerns, particularly following the Khashoggi murder. However, strategic interests, including energy security and regional stability, have necessitated continued engagement. In 2023, the U.S. lifted restrictions on certain arms sales to Saudi Arabia, signaling a potential warming of relations. The United States has actively pursued the normalization of relations between Saudi Arabia and Israel, aiming to reshape Middle Eastern geopolitics and enhance regional stability. This initiative has encountered various challenges and developments over time. The United States has long sought to facilitate diplomatic ties between Israel and Arab nations, viewing such normalization as pivotal for regional peace and countering mutual threats, particularly from Iran. The Abraham Accords of 2020, which normalized Israel's relations with the United Arab Emirates, Bahrain, and Morocco, set a precedent that the United States hoped Saudi Arabia would follow. In 2023, the Biden administration intensified efforts to broker a deal between Saudi Arabia and Israel, proposing U.S. security guarantees and assistance in developing a civilian nuclear program for Saudi Arabia as incentives. Saudi Arabia has historically linked normalization with Israel to the establishment of a Palestinian state, as outlined in the 2002 Arab Peace Initiative. However, reports in 2023 indicated that Saudi leadership was considering normalization without immediate progress on Palestinian statehood, focusing instead on strategic benefits and countering Iranian influence. Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman expressed that normalization with Israel was, for the first time, real, signaling a potential policy shift. The outbreak of conflict between Israel and Hamas in October 2023 significantly impacted normalization efforts. The violence drew international attention back to the Palestinian issue, complicating Saudi Arabia's position. The kingdom condemned Israeli military actions and, according to reports, suspended normalization talks with Israel amid the ongoing conflict. Domestically, U.S. administrations have viewed Saudi-Israeli normalization as a strategic goal. President Biden sought to achieve this as a foreign policy accomplishment, while former President Trump and his advisors have also supported such efforts. the political landscape in the U.S. influences the approach and urgency of these initiatives, with bipartisan recognition of the potential benefits of normalization. Concurrent with these developments, Saudi-Iranian military engagement has seen unprecedented developments, including naval drills in the northern Indian Ocean involving Saudi, Iranian, Russian, and other regional forces. High-level exchanges between military officials signal a cautious yet tangible shift towards collaboration. Politically, Saudi Arabia's harsh rhetoric against Israel serves a dual purpose, addressing domestic and regional sentiments over the Gaza conflict, while maintaining a nuanced stance on Iran's proxies like Hezbollah and Hamas. Despite its public disapproval of Iran's regional militancy, Riyadh seeks to mitigate threats through direct dialogue. Based on the current trajectory of their relationship, a future alliance between Saudi Arabia and Iran will likely be pragmatic and issue-driven, rather than ideologically unified. Economic cooperation, especially in sectors such as energy, trade, and infrastructure development, could serve as the cornerstone of this alliance. This relationship will also depend on mutual restraint in regional conflicts and efforts to manage proxy dynamics, as both nations aim to avoid destabilization that could derail their domestic priorities. Saudi Arabia's Vision 2030 agenda and Iran's economic revival efforts create a shared interest in regional stability, which could foster collaboration in international platforms like the BRICS group. However, the sustainability of this alliance will hinge on both nations' ability to navigate enduring mistrust and external pressures, particularly from the United States and other global powers. Strategically, the alliance will remain fluid, as Saudi Arabia seeks to hedge its bets by maintaining strong ties with the U.S. while engaging Iran to neutralize regional threats. This dual approach allows Riyadh to manage its immediate security concerns while advancing its broader economic ambitions. Iran, on the other hand, stands to gain economically and politically from reduced isolation, provided it adheres to commitments that reassure its neighbors. The evolving Saudi-Iranian relationship signals a cautious yet transformative shift in Middle Eastern geopolitics. As both nations explore avenues for cooperation, the potential for a durable and strategic partnership remains on the horizon. The geopolitical landscape of the Middle East has undergone a significant transformation since the landmark rapprochement between Saudi Arabia and Iran in 2023. The newfound cooperation between Riyadh and Tehran has manifested in various domains, including economic, military, and political spheres. The potential for a durable and strategic partnership between the two regional powers holds profound implications for the dynamics of the Middle East, with far-reaching consequences for global geopolitics. As the region navigates this complex web of alliances and rivalries, the role of external actors, particularly the United States, will continue to shape the trajectory of events. The U.S.'s approach to facilitating normalization between Saudi Arabia and Israel, as well as its evolving relationship with both nations, will be crucial in determining the stability and security of the Middle East in the years to come. Ultimately, the geopolitical landscape of the Middle East remains in flux, with the Saudi-Iranian rapprochement serving as a pivotal moment that will reverberate across the region and beyond. The ability of these nations to manage their differences, navigate external pressures, and forge a new era of cooperation will be instrumental in shaping the future of the Middle East. Thanks for watching till the end. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like and a sub so more people can see this.